I grew up in upstate New York, just outside of Troy. So I did play lots of sports growing up. I played mostly baseball, started playing tennis probably later than most, maybe around 11-ish. And I learned how to play in a public park. So my parents used to drop me off on the way to work, and I stayed at this public park all day and just played anybody and everybody, and then picked up at like 5-ish. So that's how I kind of learned how to play. And, you know, I skied and played lots of baseball, as I said, and basketball wasn't big enough for football, but I played most of the major sports. I played for a school in South Carolina. I played for Coastal Carolina College and just loved the whole team atmosphere and what the sport brought to me, not only from a physical playing experience, but also mentally, and, you know, how to work through challenges and goals and discipline, et cetera, et cetera. So I got into coaching shortly after my college playing days, and I was coaching at Duke University for a good period of time, and had a chance to compete and see the best teams in the country in Division I, and, you know, really liked the opportunity of the coaching experience and lifestyle. So, you know, a friend of mine who was actually a coach at Notre Dame at the time was at MIT at one point in his career. The opening came up, and he suggested that I look at it, and I did. And I was more intrigued by than anything else, and decided to take the position, and has loved it ever since. My favorite part of working at MIT is probably just the culture and the students. It's just a unique place. I mean, it really is unique. I just love the guys on my team. I love my students that I, you know, work with in my classroom, or you know, physical education classes. And, you know, I think it's just the people. You know, the people is what makes it so special. You know, it's just a unique niche of people. It's awesome. I love to fish and hike and camp. Pretty much love being outdoors. It's one of my long time passions. I also do a lot of photography. Probably my favorite moment with MIT tennis. We were in a conference championship match against one of our rival teams, and we were down in the final, and we have a pretty good streak going. And we were down, didn't look like we were going to do well. And it was a extremely long match. One of my guys was cramping, the opponent was cramping as well. So, you know, we're probably at the 4.5 hour mark at this point in a hot summer day. It was coming down to the wire, the last match, third set. And one of my players who ended up winning the match for us and winning the conference championship was a player who had walked on the team and just never gave up, just kind of kept working hard, and found his way into the lineup his junior year, and ended up winning, you know, one of the biggest matches of our career. So that was probably my favorite moment to date. I'm sure there's many others. A good recruit would have to be a combination of things. I mean, obviously, MIT being MIT, academics is a big, you know, sticking point for lots of potential recruits. So you have to have super high SAT scores, straight A's, taking the hardest math science classes that your school has to offer. On top of all that, you have to be an exceptionally good tennis player. So, you know, we typically like kids top 200 in the country or better. And that's just a rough guideline. But yeah, I like to prepare my team like I would any other match. I think often there's a tendency to over-prepare teams for big matches, and teams get so fired up or psyched up that they actually don't perform well. So, you know, if you're in a big postseason game, if the moment isn't big enough to get your adrenaline going and get you moving, then there's something wrong. So actually I go the opposite direction. I try to keep my players calm. I try to treat it like any other match. I try to be, you know, as calm and level-headed with them and kind of downplay it. And I feel like they tend to play better than overplaying it. The players come out. We do a quick warm-up for maybe 10 to 15 minutes, and that will vary on different stretching, you know, moving exercises. We do some light hitting, warm up all of our strokes, and then we go into match scenario type drill. So we do most of our drills are live ball. Most of our drills are match orientated live play. So, you know, we do different kind of you know, games, and we like to keep score. We like to keep things competitive. We like to keep things high energy and motivated. I like to change partners a lot. So guys are different with hitting with different guys. I like to have lots of little competitions throughout practice. So if we're doing a competitive drill, I like to keep score, high score moves up type of thing. And it keep thing, you know, keeps the guys engaged and active.